Brooklyn, stand up. LA, stand up. Matter of fact, the whole planet rock with us.
Dazzling, dilated, display a new sound.
We all live on stage.
Cry like run up in the venue like what?
Check it out, check it out.
You're now rocking with the best.
Dazzling, dilated, display a new sound.
We all live on stage.
And we do it for you.
Yeah, we do it for you.
Come on, we do it for you.
Live on stage.
Bing, 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 bing.
What's going on?
You tuned into the Pick'em S-Twitch live show now because Apple Podcasts, you heard me, what's good? It's your boy, Young Leg, a.k.a. Anthony Chopa. I got the whole gang here with me. I got Tweeter with me, I got Oaks with me, and I got the one, the only, King of the North, Cotton himself. How are we doing, fellas?
Fantastic. Great. Ready for season two.
I mean, you're late. If we're being honest, Cotton, soft move. Congratulations, Cotton did have to plan a whole engagement last weekend, so we'll give him a pass, everybody. He still got some picks in as well. So
thank you. I feel like that's a valid reason. Thank you.
It's up there. It's up there with family emergency and whatnot for missing the Kick'em. I mean, season two debut, but
right.
Congrats.
Thank you.
Yeah, we're happy for you, though. We're happy for you.
Thank you, guys. Now I'm going to go ahead and win this competition.
Whatever helps.
Oh, yeah, right. Did you see my fire come on yesterday?
Wait. Before we get into this, can I just say, please make sure you update the win or loss column so I can calculate the fucking percentages for the week, please?
That's fair. I feel like, but I mean, I do have one thing to say. I mean, my first bet of the new season was Arsenal and Bond. I mean,
that's the first fuck you. That's a great segue. That's perfect.
That was a great segue. I was honestly just going to let Bond go off about how shit his fucking team is, because my fuck you is to Arsenal.
They're bad.
Yeah, it's Arsenal and Leipzig. Leipzig, what the hell was that?
Fuck Leipzig. Yo, big what fuck Leipzig, bro. I dropped 50 on live.
Dude, I was having such a good Bundesliga weekend, too. Bayern, that little hiccup, but I mean, Lewandowski scored for me, and they hit the over, so I wasn't that mad about that one. But for Leipzig, the 70% possession stinker they just put up on Mainz, I'm glad that Arsenal was earlier in the week, just so we could get mad about it on a Friday, because not only did they fucking lose, but they also didn't score. And I know a hefty amount of us had both teams to score. That's all I'll say.
Chelsea minus one this week.
Oh, man. We'll get into that. Any other fuck yous by anyone?
Fuck anybody that didn't tell my picks. I went 10 for 13, so you guys got to start recognizing.
Yeah, so the win losses, I picked way more than 13. I ended up going – I went 43 and 27.
Yep.
I made 70 picks. Once you like see the lineups and everything, I'm one of those people. I'm just like, man, both teams to score. This guy's gonna score. Maybe this guy'll get an assist. Like, I just throw him the fuck on. Like, I'll just sit with my laptop in front of me, on the just board, and just like, throw in like 8 picks. Yeah. Or it's like, I might be at work at that time, and I'll throw in like 9 picks.
I'm the new guy, so like, I thought adding 4 MLS picks was getting a little excessive. I didn't know y'all were dropping 70 on the board.
Nope. No, I'm throwing. Dude, if I'm watching,
put it out there. Just throw it out there. All right, bet.
I got an average of 30 out there. Leg likes to go in the 70 plus category, and it somehow works out for him. But to each his own.
Yo, numbers never lie. 61% accuracy for Leg. Bondi with a cool 45 and 36. So Bondi starting his year positive as well. 55% accuracy, and then the other two. You know, Cotton was busy getting engaged. Congrats again. And Oaks is new. So those are their excuses for week one.
Hey, I don't have any excuses, man. I'm Baroque 77, and I went 77% on my picks. So what else you want?
I mean, I was going to say, if you just follow Oak on fucking Twitter, you realize that he spews out picks every 15 fucking minutes. And then make sure that TwoFootTalk is also spewing out those picks. And then I'm just like, well, fuck, I got to spew out those picks. So Oaks is just a bad influence in all of this for me. But at the same time, we're getting money out here.
I did clean sweep Champions League today.
I literally only hit on Celtic and Malmo. And then I got a bet with my heart most of the time, so I took the PSV plus a half and was heartbroken, even though a huge second half. Great job, guys. Cotton, do we want to talk about your Wolves, or are we just going to – it looks like you might have a Wolves kit on.
Got a red for the first game. They looked a lot better than I actually thought they were going to look last game against Leicester. Vardy got the goal on them. They had like 17 shots or something. I didn't get to watch it live. But, yeah, I mean, I think they have a tough game in Tottenham against the old boss next week. So I'll talk a little bit about that on my board. But, yeah, other than that, I mean, it's pretty much as expected. I think they're going to be mid to bottom table this year. So I think the goal is to hopefully get, you know, 12th or higher. So we'll see how it goes.
So A-Dog made a great point. Fan vote percentage is 100% so far this year. They had Everton money line, hell of a comeback by Everton. So props to the fan vote. We'll do another audience pick later later in the episode.
Colin, did you only put 3 picks in for this week?
And they all lost. So I was 0-3. Really bad on the percentage this week.
Yeah. Hate to put that in there.
Yeah, to just throw it out. I was trying to avoid it.
Right under the bus.
That's the first 0% we've ever seen on the kicking boards.
I think history. So. I just got to go 100% this week.
Yeah, there you go.
Anyway, we'll get right into these games. The first one I got on the board, just because I love the odds, and both these teams are exciting teams, a little bit hard to pick. I got Leeds versus Everton. So you know how me and Bond roll. Bond's repping Leeds right now. We always take Leeds, and we always take Leeds overs. But this Everton team... I mean, DCL and Richarlison both scoring. I appreciate that hit for me as well. Shout out Richarlison, carry that form over from the summer. But the only thing I'm definitely looking at here is the over, because one, we know Leeds still can't really defend. We just watch fucking Man U light them the fuck up. But also it's Bielsa ball. I don't know if Everton's going to be able to handle that Bielsa pressure. So I'm looking at the over immediately. I think the odds are kind of like dead on. I think Leeds are like favored by a little. My book was like had them at like plus 145-ish, and then Everton was like plus 165, plus 170-ish. So, Oaks, what do you think of this one?
This is a tough one because Leeds absolutely got shit stomped by Man U. Shout out Man U. Pogba's still that dude. Like you said, Leeds can't defend with a shit. They do score. They only got one, but again, Manchester was just being a wagon. Everton shit stomped Southampton. I like both teams to score in this one, but I was fading this really hard because of the numbers. I didn't find a ton of juice that I loved there. Didn't particularly want to take a side on either of this. So both teams to score would be my play, but I didn't even write it down or find a number for it.
Bondi, what are you thinking here?
I mean, let's be honest. Big shout out to VD in the chat, though. 007 gang, keep doing your thing. For me, I mean, you know, I got to go with Leeds, buddy. It's Leeds. Leeds money line, and you take the over, whatever the fuck the over is. That's all you need to do.
Hold on. Just for VD really quick, Cotton, he's one of our Wolves fans. If you want to just throw up the jersey for him real quick, give him a little peek at the chest.
I didn't know they existed, so thanks for joining.
But yeah, this one, like we said, defense is going to be rough for Leeds and Everton, with that Bielsa ball, that pressure. We'll see. I love the over. If it stays around 3 or it goes under 3, I'm fucking hammering that. Cotton, what do you think really leads Everton game?
So before I talk about that, I mean, can we get some Bruno credits and Bruno props from last week?
Okay. Yeah. Bruno, way to just get completely walking goals from Pogba.
Oh, plus, give me a play
next
break.
To the best midfielder on the world.
Garbage. Listen, dumpster fire. He's not that good.
Do it again.
One excuse is from the penalty spot. Another excuse is that he's getting walk-ins from Pogba. I mean, he's finishing. Those are 3 excellent finishes, and it was against Leeds. So I had to point that out. I'm sorry.
Great game by him. Great season. After a shit summer he had, I was a little nervous for him. But apparently, Bruno Windcast are still the move for Manchester United.
I'll get to Bruno. We'll get to Bruno, and he'll have a fantastic season. For this game, I got Everton in a pick. I just didn't like the way Leeds looked coming out against Man United. Everton, like you said, had a great comeback. They showed a lot of heart under Benitez's first game. So I'm kind of leaning towards them. Even though Leeds is home, I think a pick them is a safe call.
He also still hasn't signed the contract, Bond. Are you nervous? Because I'm not. He also ball, baby. Stuart, what's going on, my guy? All right, next game I got for you guys. Do we want to keep it English right now?
Yeah.
Yeah, let's do it.
All right, Bond.
Chelsea -1.
It is the second match week of the season, and Bond's faith in Arsenal is dead. It's gone.
Completely. See, rightfully so.
They lost to Brentford. Like, let's think about this for a second. Brentford hadn't won a Premier League game in 75 years. They come in 2-0. Shocked that it happened. Totally. No, fuck Arsenal. They suck. They're dead to me at this point. They suck unless they figure something out, spend some money. But did I not say Brentford plays some extremely good football? I'm just going to point that out. But yeah, Chelsea minus one. Fuck Arsenal.
I was impressed by Brentford. Not so much my man Tony up front. Maybe a little lackluster after all the hype. But, you know, he'll work his way into it. He's still going to bag G's. So we'll see what happens with the Brentford. We'll talk about that maybe a little bit later. But this one, the only thing that I will say is that every time I think Chelsea are going to shithouse Arsenal, Arsenal somehow wins. So I don't even think I'm going to touch a money line here at all. I might take both teams to score. I might look at an over. I might look at a few goal scorers. But I don't think I'm even going to touch this game because I don't trust Arsenal. I feel like this was a setup. I feel like they want me to hammer Chelsea the way that Bond is already pushing for it. And I feel like Vegas is just trying to play me, and Arsenal's going to actually show up. Lacazette and Aubameyang are going to actually play in the game. Yeah, we all forgot that they didn't have their two main strikers and only goal scorers. So, Oaks, what do you think of this one?
Pepe still exists.
Pepe sucks. Not worth right. 72 million.
Oh, probably not 72 million. He's stupid fast. Just feed him the ball, keep him on sides. Anyway, I'm waiting for Lopes to come out. I don't have an official play on this. I want to see where Mason Mount lines up. I love Mount assists. His assist numbers are always super juicy. Depending on how they line up, if they got him up top or if they got him playing like back a little bit, I might take him for an assist and a goal. But yeah, without those two guys on Arsenal, I'm gonna butcher their names. But yeah, I take Chelsea in a shit stopping here.
Yeah, it's a little I don't know. It's a different game when Aubameyang's actually on the pitch because, there's the main guy. There's the guy that's been fighting for the golden boot the last fucking four seasons. So, I don't know. I think it could be a different game. At the same time, this is Arteta ball, and my man is trash. I have no respect for Arteta. I have no respect for Arsenal football right now. So, I don't even know if they're going to sign either of these players, and they're going to stick around. Cotton, what do you have in this game?
Yeah, after last week, I especially got Chelsea money. Took them just on the money line versus Arsenal. I'm going to be watching Arsenal a little bit this year, I think, with Nuno Tavares coming in. I'm excited to see what he can do. I think he got subbed in late last game. But other than that, I'm not really too high on Arsenal this year at all. So Chelsea money line was the easy pick for me there.
I will say Odegaard also just signed for Arsenal, $40 million from Real Madrid. So, I mean,
it's a good deal.
It's just a shame Odegaard decided he was a bitch. But if you want to go over to Arsenal, go make some bread, go hopefully get an opportunity. I feel like Arsenal kind of now just have like a shit ton of attacking mids that they're going to have to just kind of rotate around or move them into who knows what kind of formation. So, still not sure what money line means. It just means that team's going to win, essentially. That's the easiest way I can break it down for you. You're picking that to win.
That means no draw.
GD is a wild statement there at the bottom.
Madrid is a toxic club. I'm glad everyone is leaving.
Yo, La Liga dead to me, bro. I didn't pick a single La Liga game today.
All right, speaking of La Liga, no, I'm just kidding. I'll do that. Wolves versus Tottenham. I thought Tottenham looked fantastic. I thought Tottenham looked great. And you want to talk about somebody that knows Wolves team in and out. I mean, kind of a shitty matchup for Wolves, if we're being honest. And what was Tottenham's line? I think it was around like plus 128. So I was just like, okay. I know Raul Jimenez is back. I know that he's due for a goal. So that's why I'm kind of looking at both teams to score here. I'm looking at Tottenham money line here. And of course, Ronaldo, the fucking GOAT. Probably my favorite player in the Premier League, for being completely honest. Anytime Son gets the ball, it's fucking deadly. He does some smooth-ass shit. He has some shit that's out of pocket that you didn't think he was going to be able to do. So I'm a big fan of Tottenham money line here. Wolves, I'm really just banking on him and as to finally score again. I know he's going to get one. I know he's due for one. It's kind of like that welcome back to the league type of goal that he needs to, like, let everyone know I'm still here. So that's what I'm expecting him to get, because Tottenham's defense, they're very physical, but he's a big boy and he knows how to play with his body as well as having good control and being a decent finisher. The only problem is that a lot of crosses are coming in, and I don't know if he's like – he might have the yips when it comes to going in the air right now after what happened after the skull injury. So we'll see. Cotton, I'll go right to you about your Wolves here.
Yeah, so, you know, I mean, you said it best. I'm going to be playing against Nuno Santos' team. I mean, I think the favor is in their hands right now, in the Spurs' hands. I was surprised to even see the line at a pick'em for Tottenham, so that's what I took. Obviously, I'm going to want Wolves to win. I just, you know, especially after last week, I'm just not sure they have the offense right now to get it done. And I don't think Jimenez is 100% back. I mean, I think he's going to be, like you said, whether it's the yips, whatever you want to call it, if you fracture your skull, you're going to be a little hesitant to get back in there and fight for the balls like he was so good at doing. So we'll see. I got Tottenham pick him for this game, though.
Oaks, what do you got?
I like Tottenham a lot. Y'all mentioned it. They got the new manager that used to coach for Wolves' son. I got huge on that. Shout out my boy JD from Twitter. Bet with him all last year. Dude is in my brain like a motherfucker. Took Son anytime. Saw the Son over 0.5 shots on goal for minus 140. Dropped a hundo on that. So that was a nice bag right there. But, yeah, so I'm taking Tottenham. I'm taking Son anytime. Taking Son over one shot on goal. If they're dumb enough to hang with minus 140 on that again, I'm going to hammer the shit out of that.
Do we know if Harry Kane's playing? I know he's back in training.
Nobody knows.
A week now? Is he playing?
I have no idea.
I low-key like watching them without him. I fucking hate watching Harry Kane. I hate how he plays as like a big man.
Send the ball more.
Ducking under people's shit and whatnot and diving all over the place. I like Son being the focal point of the attack and then just – fuck it. Like, if Odegaard went to Tottenham, I would love to see Odegaard linking up with Son or somebody of that caliber. Lucas Moura was dribbling a shit ton. I don't know why the fuck he was dribbling so much. I'm so happy not to have Fabrizio Romano there. So, I don't even know what we're talking about here, VD. Leave my Madrid alone, bro. Harry Kane to Madrid now? We'll see if City wants to pay that money for him. Apparently 150 was the number, so I'm not really sure about that one. Bondi, do I have one to ask?
Wolves money line, fuck Tottenham, fuck Kane, fuck everything about that goddamn
thing. All right.
No rationale behind it. Literally.
What's up, Bond? Love it.
All right, next one. We're going over to Germany. I got Leipzig versus Stuttgart. Honestly, the only reason I put this on here is because Leipzig played so bad and Stuttgart looked fucking great. That was a great pickup also. I don't know if anyone got in on that money line, but the fucking value on it was fantastic. Leipzig, though, I don't really know what we're going to get. And, like, Bond, I've lost a little faith in Jesse Marsh. I'll be completely honest here. After that first fucking game I just watched. Bondi, what do you think of this?
Different league, man. Different league. I think he needs to adjust a little bit to – I mean, the Austrian league, the German league, very, very similar. But I think he needs to – adjust a little bit more with his tactics, because I think everything's just a very, very much more refined when it comes to the Bundesliga. And honestly, I think, yeah, tough start, but I think he'll be able to right the ship. I just don't know how much time they're going to give him, given how successful Leipzig has been. And I mean, the smart play for clubs nowadays is if the manager's not getting it done, they just off him. And that's just the way it plays. You make bank fading Bond. Yo, A-Dog, I was in the black this week. Like, on all 81 of my picks, you actually made money.
He said all 81 picks. Anyway, Oaks, what do you got in this one?
I got Leipzig goal in both halves, minus 103. Love this number. Love the juice on it. They dominated every facet of that game. They controlled the ball 70% of the time, had triple the shots on goal. They dominated every piece of that game except for the scoreboard. And they got the bullshit. They got an offsides rule or some shit to get the other second goal disallowed. If Leipzig doesn't come out with some fucking fire, I will fade them for the rest of the season. Real talk. So they better come out firing. Don't look back. Get a goal both halves. Leipzig.
I feel like anytime I start to like have a creeping doubt about Leipzig, then their money line and over usually hits the next week. So I'll probably be on that money line and the over. I'm going to look at an Andre Silva goal again just because Andre Silva was hot as fuck last season. He knows how to score in the Bundesliga. And he's the only man up top. They've switched their formation where it's just him as the focal point. I was hoping my man Nkunku would get some more runs in down the wing, but we'll see what they do for next match with Jesse Marsh. Cotton.
I got Leipzig on here. If you look at Stuttgart's lineup, they got like a shit ton of their tire. So I think it's not going to be the same Stuttgart you saw last season. That was they're making it competitive. And I think the line's not reflected yet. So.
Gotcha. You're cutting out a little bit, but I know you're on Leipzig, so I trust you. other German one I got, Leverkusen versus Gladbach. I mean, I love when – I feel like Gladbach plays up to their competition, so I think this is going to be one of those games for Gladbach where they play up because they seem to just have like a shit show of a match anytime they play somebody that they should easily beat, but then they'll go and compete against Bayern Munich, who's an absolute wagon. So I love this match. I love the over on this match if it stays at 2.5. I'm leaning towards Gladbach, believe it or not, but mostly so I can do a pick 'em and so I can cover myself if there is a draw. Bondi, what are you thinking in this one?
Well, I don't know, Dick, again, about Bundesliga because I don't bet it anymore because it went me, fucked me last year. So, you know, I'll just stick with my shitty leagues that I bet. You know, I'm partial to Gladbach, having Fabian Johnson been on the team a decade ago, but it's, yeah. Why not? Let's go with Gladbach this game. Why not?
Folks, you love that? You love that methodology from Bond right there?
I'll be honest with you guys. I didn't have this one on my card. I have a look on the Dortmund game. I got a look on the Wolfsburg game. I did not have a look on the Gladbach game.
Cotton, what do you got for me?
I had Gladbach plus half a goal. That's what I got the line at versus Leverkusen. It was pretty much seeing the draw against Bayern, which, you know, I bet Bayern. I didn't think Gladbach was going to have it in them. They got the draw done, and I think they carry kind of that energy. I feel like if you get a draw versus Bayern this early in the season, it kind of feels like a win for them. So I'm going to take them plus half a goal against Leverkusen.
Wasky Woo, check DraftKings. I caught Club America, even money, 100. I hammered that as well.
No free ads, though.
Yeah, no free ads. Just shop your numbers. Find the right book, shop your numbers, get the best value for your money.
Next one we got, we're going over to France. I got Nice versus Marseille because Nice fucking lit Lille up. They lit the defending champs up. And Marseille, I mean, they looked good in the preseason. And, you know, they're still doing their thing. They're getting results. I think they're tied on points with Nice right now. So I'm mostly just watching it for Conrad De La Fuente and to see if Nice is actually legit. I know they have a great manager. I think they stole Lille's manager from last year. So I think they're going to make a little bit of a run here. That's why I'm running with Nice and I'm running with both teams to score. These are both very offensive sides from what I've watched so far in the French league.
Set Marseille shit down their leg last game, fucking gave up a 2-0 lead at half, and then conceded like, I don't know, six fucking corners.
Fuck off. I'm talking about goals, dog. Oaks, what do you got in this one?
I didn't have this one on my card, but yeah, I'll take Nice. I'm gonna fade the shit on Marseille. I had Marseille money line, they went up 2-0 at half, and they completely shit down their leg and took a red at the end to fuck up my French parlay. So, yeah, fuck Marcel. I'm going to take Nice.
I'm not going to ask Bond because I know how he feels about the French league, so we don't need any of his slander.
I ride with Nice, though.
Patrick Vieira's old squad?
Because fuck Marseille, because, you know, it's all about Lyon.
Facts.
I got a hot French game if we don't have any more French games on the schedule.
Yeah, go ahead. Hit me with it.
right, so I really like Claremont's chance this week. They're quietly having an excellent season. They're 2-0 as a promoted team. Lion is absolute hot garbage right now.
They're relaxed.
Jesus.
What?
Very relaxed. You're talking shit on my guys over at Lyon.
Well, dude, they fucking took a 1-1 draw at home and then got shit stomped on the road 3-0. Yeah, Claremont double chance, plus 148. Book it.
I'm fading the fuck out of Oaks, and I'm taking Lyon money line, maybe Lyon minus one.
This is a Lyon podcast.
We'll see. Today. I'm fading the fuck out of them. Cotton, do you have anything for that one?
I actually took Lyon minus one. I think they had a nice bounce back game there. And then for the Marseille game, I had Marseille because same reason. I kind of wanted to root for De La Fuente, but I kind of forgot Nice was the team that fucked Lille over last weekend. So I might just take that off my board completely.
Yeah, you're getting those mixed emotions now. That's when you just take it right off the board.
Yeah, I mean, I don't really feel strongly about Marseille anyway, so I'm out on that one.
Can't blame you. Let me get over to Bonds boys over in Roma. We got Roma versus Fiorentina. I'm just really excited about this because Serie A's back. Very fun one to bet on, especially if you like Atalanta overs, you like Juventus money lines, you like Inter not anymore. They're
both teams to score.
Lazio, Immobile, I think is going to be hot. Still, yo, if you guys go look at Immobile to be top scorer, it's still plus 1,100 on DK. So I'm just saying, worth a couple sprinkles.
Tammy Abram, top scorer.
Tammy Abram is also over at Roma, which is why I love this game. I actually made a parlay for Serie A. So whenever we talk about the Parlay Cup after this, we can we'll talk about that. But I love Roma in this game. This is Mourinho, new team, first game, kind of announcing himself to Serie A again. They watched him dominate with Inter, what was that, like 11 years ago, 12 years ago now. So I love Roma here. Fiorentina has that fucking very, very good midfield, though, which I'm not really sure if Roma's can compete with them yet. Is Zaniolo back to 100% fit, Bon?
I don't think he's 100%, but I wouldn't be surprised if you see him play 45, 50 minutes.
Okay, so Bondi, what are you thinking for this game?
Oh, dude, fucking take Roma. Roma money line. I mean, I got to see what the spread is on it, but if it's Roma minus a half, I might just bump that to minus 0.75, try and get a little more juice on it. But yeah, Roma's going to come out. I mean, if Tammy Abram plays, we'll probably see a goal from him. Zaniolo, if he gets those minutes, probably be looking good out there. I'm just excited to see what the team looks like with Mourinho, if I'm being honest. But yeah, they're going to walk away with a victory. So. Roma money line, and if the spread's favorable, take Roma on the spread.
I'm all in on a Tammy Abraham goal. I want that. If he doesn't start, I'm going to be really pissed off. I'll be completely honest with you. Oaks, what do you got in this game?
I found, I don't know, did anybody find a better line than minus 129 Roma?
No. I haven't really looked at it too hard. I'm kind of just waiting to see if it's going to go up or down in the coming days here.
I got minus 129 was the best number I found on that, and I'm going to smash Roma like it's a double Jack and Coke, and last call is about to come up.
I love it.
Cotton, what do you got for this one?
Yeah, so I took Roma. I took Roma money line, and I also took the over three in this game. I think Mourinho is going to come out gun blazing. And sometimes, I mean, as of late, he hasn't really been the park the bus, or at least he's trying to, and his defenses haven't been capable. So it's kind of blowing the game open. We saw that at Spurs, and, you know, I'm wondering what we're going to see here at Roma. We kind of got a little taste of that over the summer. I think they got blown out by Batiste, but I'm rooting for them. I think they get the win here, and I hope Abraham plays. I didn't even know he was going to be ready to be playing for this game. So,
well, he's been ready to play. It's just that he needs someone to play him. That's why I thought it was disrespectful as fuck when Chelsea was like, oh, we needed a more consistent striker. And it's like, your fucking striker needed a more consistent field to go on. Like, what the fuck? Look at his numbers. His numbers are just crazy.
Yeah, no, they are. Sometimes I just get, you know, with these transfers, you'll hear, like, I mean, Lukaku with Chelsea, right? Like, I thought that happened, like, 3 weeks ago. But, like, I don't know when the fuck he's going to play. Like, I guess I got to wait and see now, so.
Chelsea a wagon anyway, though.
Yeah.
That's what you think, and then they somehow choke, and then they fire their manager, get a new one, and then they'll win another fucking trophy.
Is that King Joseph Oh, just off.
I was literally gonna remove this kid if he was just rooting against the Union. That's all I'm gonna say. Cause I have a dupe, so I'll cue the fuck up for when we score. I'm not worried about shit. We're out here, Philly. Anyway.
Nah.
Those are the only game I had in the Serie A. I don't know if anyone wants to like talk Atalanta versus Torino, but the rest of them were just kind of like I would just end up taking all chalk because I have no faith in any of the new promoted teams or any of the bottom feeders from last year.
Atalanta, all I got over 2.5.
What'd you say?
Oh, I got.
I said Atalanta -2 over 3.5.
-2.
Yep.
-2. Damn. Torino is hot garbage, but I'm not going -2.
I got -1. Yeah, I got -1 so, Atalanta.
The only thing I got to say about Atalanta is stop fucking taking red cards. Stop taking red cards and fucking me in my parlays. So, yeah, don't do that anymore, Atalanta.
Bologna's playing that other new team who's Salernitana. I don't know.
Bologna got their shit pumped in that fucking Italian Cup game the other day. I think it was like, I don't know, 12 goals or some shit. Like, I think both sides, it was 6-5 last time I checked in on it. But yeah, Bologna was getting absolutely shit pumped. And then I obviously am going to take Ronaldo anytime, Ronaldo for a brace, and Ronaldo for a hat trick because fuck it.
I like this guy.
Oh, Cotton's a big Portuguese guy. Don't worry, you'll figure that out soon. Moving on to the greatest league on the planet, Bond, because you know what? It's not soccer.
It's La Liga.
All right, so La Liga football, baby. Barcelona's taking on Athletic Bilbao, the best country boys. Bilbao, I'm not going to lie to you, fucking struggled to score. And it was against a garbage team, and they lost me money. So a little upset with them. Whereas Barcelona looks fucking fantastic, which is why everyone's like, oh, what are they going to do without Messi? It's like, I don't know. Use one of the other $100 million players they have. There's fucking four more on the team. On top of Pedri still there. Somehow Pedri has played 73 games this year, and he is just not tired. Like, he is just such a teenager with it. It's fucking crazy. Dude never gets tired. PK is giving up money now all of a sudden. He couldn't do it during the pandemic, but now he's giving up money so Memphis Depay can play. Eric Garcia can play. Frank de Jong still doing his thing. Barcelona absolutely shit pumped Real Sociedad. And really tough start to the season, if we're being completely honest. Real Sociedad right into the Basque Country boys. So I'm going to take Barcelona here, probably -1. Bilbao is also down both of their fullbacks and I think a center back. So they're playing with a lot of replacements on that back line. So I really do think that Barcelona is going to shit pump them. And Breathwaite pretty much used up all his goals from last week. So I'm going to probably go with a Griezmann or a Depay goal. Oaks, what do you got for me?
I got fuck La Liga. 2-2 standalone, 0-0 open draws. I don't bet La Liga. Fuck La Liga. Also, I just saw in the group chat Kevin Durant at the Union game cheering on the Union. So let's go, Union.
Okay. We're getting a little Union love here. All right. I like it. Bondi, what do you got in this one? Barcelona versus Athletic Bilbao.
Probably Barcelona, for being honest. I hate to do it. I'm just going to be honest. It kind of sucks. It's eating at my soul just saying that. But I think they're going to walk out of here with the victory. What was the spread on this game?
Probably like -1.25. -1.5.
Yeah, I mean, if you could bump it up to like -1.75, I definitely think Barca is going to win by at least 2. So
it was actually minus. I got it -0.5.
So, what? Dead ass? Oh, hell yeah.
Take it at -1. Like, I mean, take it at -1 then. Like, better odds for that. But, I mean, I don't think Athletic is going to come out. Bilbao is going to come out and do the thing. So,
hey, anybody waiting on MLS stuff? I just got Orlando's lineup. No Messi, no Nani. So, I'm not taking Nashville, but I'm just not playing that game. Nani's, everybody knows Nani's my boy. Anytime goal, anytime Nani stops on the field.
I have Nashville and I have CJ to score, so fuck Orlando again.
That Nani talk
you got me hyped, dude. You gotta get me going on MLS now.
Yo, fact. MLS is way better than La Liga. Whoever said that in the chat, appreciate you, dog. La Liga fucking 2-0-0 games on a Tuesday. Eat my ass.
It's a wild statement.
Guess who didn't win in La Liga? How do I point to him? There it is. I was cooking. Shout out, Atleti. Shout out, Batiste. You kind of fucked me. But I took you on a pick, so I'm not that mad. Anyway, last La Liga game. You know we had to do it. Real Madrid versus Levante. Real Madrid's money line is only like minus 170, but I'm still taking Madrid minus one because that's just what I do. Benzema to score. Easy. Pretty much just cash a check right now.
Yep.
Oaks.
Yeah, I'll take a Benzema win cast.
Cut.
Putting the mortgage on Levante. That's
so great. Shout out, dude.
I got Real minus one and Benzema goal also. So I'm pretty confident in that, honestly. They look really good first game. So,
guys, that wasn't even the starting defense also. Just saying. Bruce wasn't even in, guys. Just saying. We started Bale and still beat their ass. Pretty embarrassing for them.
Alright, just more than fucking two goals.
What'd you say?
I said, wake me up when they start scoring more than two goals a game.
All Are you sides. Talking about Madrid?
I'm talking about any fucking midweek La Liga match that literally is just a fucking snooze fest.
You know what's going to happen this week? It's going to be an absolute goal fest. And Burr's
and then I'll be all in. I'll be all in. And then I'll probably lose all my money.
Bondi, where are you going? You following us into the sunset, me and Cotton?
I will ride with you guys into the sunset.
Let's go.
All right, that's all I got for La Liga. That's all I got for my games. Anyone else have any games they want to mention? Oh, wait, hold on. Do I have one more? I have one more EPL. Sorry, guys. West Ham versus Leicester. It was all the way at the bottom of my list.
That's on Monday, bro.
Yeah, I know.
Okay. I thought we were doing weekend picks.
No,
well, yeah, we do all week.
All right.
Wednesday to Wednesday.
Yep.
Cool. I'm new. I'm a new guy. I haven't figured this shit out yet.
Get up to speed, bro.
Why do you think I have 81 picks on the board?
I thought we just did Friday, Saturday, Sunday picks, dog.
Those were all Friday, Saturday, Sunday picks.
I know those were all Friday, Saturday, Sunday picks.
Unbelievable, bro.
Oh, shit. I'm taking both teams to score. I know Leicester was a little slow on offense last week, but, you know, first week jitters. Jamie Vardy still pulled through for us.
And no Nacho.
Nacho hopefully will be back for Oak's sake. I know he doesn't want to keep betting just Vardy goals. So, I mean, West Ham, they had a decent little comeback. They mounted, and I like both teams to score here. I'll probably end up taking an over two, and I don't know. Did Madison get hurt last game? It seemed like he had to get subbed off, and he looked like he was he had a knock or something going on. So I'm not sure if he's definitely going to be starting or not. But Vardy or Ihe and Nacho goal is pretty much what we're looking at here, and I'm going to go both teams to score. Cotton, what do you think for this game?
I think I'm actually really excited for this game because West Ham, I didn't know what to expect after last season, like coming in, if they were like really, you know, really a fun team to watch or if they were frauds, but they went, got a nice comeback, scored four goals. And Leicester won as well. So I didn't really know who to pick for this, and I took the over 2.5. I think that's going to hit. I'm pretty confident in that.
Bondi, what do you want for this one?
I mean, I'm taking Leicester. What did I take them?
They were like plus 175. Like, they weren't even favored in this.
Yeah. No, I took Leicester money line here. I wouldn't be surprised. Like, because to me, Barty's like a hot streak guy. Like, he started off with a goal. I think you're going to see him score in probably five or six consecutive games. So I would definitely ride the Vardy to score streak on that, barring any injuries. And VD put it in the chat. It's just a little hiccup for Madison there. So I wouldn't be like he's gonna play, but I wouldn't be shocked if you see him get subbed out a little bit earlier, similar to last week. So, but yeah, Leicester on the money line. It's gonna be a good game though. I think it's gonna be a really good game to watch. Probably one of the better ones to watch this weekend.
from a Premier League. I'm not even including Chelsea Arsenal in that because that's going to be a fucking dumpster fire. If you want to see Arsenal get shit on, by all means, watch that fucking game.
Oaks, what do you got for this game?
I love both teams to score. Love over 2.5. You guys know I'm a Nacho guy. I'm a big Vardy guy. Vardy shotgun and Red Bulls and guns. That's just a legend. And but I also really like Michael Antonio from Blam. Again, shout out my boy JD from Twitter. He was my brain all weekend picking the same shit as me. So I like him. And I like Muhammad. I'm going to – for Hama, I don't know. I'm going to put his last name, but I like him for an assist too from West Ham. I'm not going to pick a winner. I'm just going to take both teams to score, and I'm going to have some player props for that. But, yeah, I love that game.
All right, so those are the only games I had to talk about. Anyone else have any notable games they wanted to mention? Are you guys all good?
No, I got
– Scottish League is back, man.
Shut up, Bond.
I got a couple more EPL games I wouldn't mind talking about. I like Villa money line minus 125. Villa at home should get a nice boost with the fans being back. They took a tough fall to a newly promoted team. So I like Villa. I don't know what I'm going to do. I think Brentford draw no bet minus 103 is a pretty good price. I know Arsenal did have their strikers on the field and looked like ass, but I hate Crystal Palace. You guys heard me last week. I took them as a borderline relegation team, so I think Brentford draw no bet here is a nice value with getting your money back. Man, you probably gonna take Pogba for assist. Let's be honest. That looked really good there. I like I like Dortmund to win and both teams to score at plus 163. They just are coming off a tough L in the Super Cup. They should bounce back. Their defense is shit. But Haaland is a savage, and if they can push pressure on the net, they should do very well. And then in PSG's debut, I am definitely smashing Messi, first goal scorer, plus 250. That's a no-brainer. Just got to do it. And then over in a tiny league, I like Lazio money line, minus 134. So that's all I had. Another shit. I couldn't even get MLS lines for Saturday because everybody's playing today.
Yeah, it's always the fucking worst with MLS. Yo, what is a corner match bet? Oaks, do you know what a corner match bet is? Because I sure as fuck don't.
Corner match bet is that whatever you can take draw or either team and whichever team can get more corners. So, like, right now on the TV I got Atlanta playing Toronto on a corner match bet that you can take. Which team is going to have the most corners, Atlanta, Toronto, or draw?
Gotcha. So it's just pretty much like picking a winner in the actual game, but just for the corner.
Correct. It's like a money line.
Corners. All right. I got my 10 picks. Cotton, you got your 10 picks to give?
Yes, sir.
Bond, you got your 10?
I don't have 10. I have 6.
Right. That works too, because we all know that it's going to be exactly fucking English third league and the Scottish league.
Yeah, pretty much.
Let me hear what you got, Bond.
All right. So what I got. The first one was Chelsea, Arsenal. I took Chelsea minus 1. We already talked about that, so I won't bore anybody too much more with that. Going down to the championship, we got West Brom versus Blackburn. This is honestly like West Brom probably going to get back promoted. They're one of those swinger teams that you see going back and forth from the championship to the Prem. They're absolutely ran through the championship the last two weekends. So, yeah, I wouldn't be surprised to see them come out here get a win.
They did shit on Sheffield as well. They just beat them like 4-0 today.
Yeah, I know. Yeah. And then next one is Fulham versus Hull City. I'm taking Fulham money line. Again, I think Fulham, I wouldn't be surprised if they stay down in the championship another year, but they're one of those teams that might be right back up.
Hull City just got back up to the championship. So Dwyer's tweets earlier is like, what the fuck is Hull doing? I mean, I think they got to re-engage at the championship level, which is just a little bit higher than the League One level, which Hull City ran through last year. But I wouldn't be surprised if you see Fulham come walk away here with a 1-0 win. I think Hull City is going to fix what was wrong this past weekend and really come out firing, but I would still take a Fulham money line that game. And then we got three Scottish Premiership games. First up, we got Celtic versus St. Mirren. Last I checked, the line for Celtic was -1 versus St. Mirren, and I would hammer that all day. If that goes up to like 1.5, I don't know if I would hit that just because you never know. It's not the Celtic of 10 years ago that's out there. I mean, they're a little more lackluster, I would say, nowadays, which is unfortunate because I always enjoyed watching them play. But they're going to handle St. Mirren pretty easily.
Right now, too. They got like a 6-game win streak, maybe longer.
Yeah. Next up, we got Rangers versus Ross County. Rangers, tough start to the season for them. But Stevie G is going to turn it around. The line is sitting at -1.75 to the Rangers. So I would take that against Ross County. I mean, Ross County's a decent Scottish side, but they're not up to the level of, I would say, Aberdeen.
No, Revolution tie. Sorry.
No, that's fine. Just that there's probably more interesting than what I'm talking about. Aberdeen and Hibernian are at. So I think Rangers are going to have their way with Ross County if Stevie G is able to right the ship, which is what I'm banking on, betting Rangers to spread here, which is at -1.75. And last but not least, I'm going to throw a legs Scottish boys in here, St. Johnstone, as you would like to say, versus Dundee United, not to be confused with there's a Dundee team that made it up to the Scottish Premiership this year. But I think Johnstone's going to handle Dundee United. Dundee United, these teams are very, very equal, I would say. But I think Johnstone is gonna walk away with the victory here. I just think they're a little bit better coached. And they got the support of the leg, which counts for a lot in the Scottish Premier League, apparently. Because as I was talking shit on St. Johnstone, and then leg started betting them, and they started winning. So, I mean, I feel like you got to ride with legs hot hands on that one. So, St. Johnstone money line. And those are my picks. I didn't want to bore everybody with all the picks from the championship and league 2.
Cotton, what do you got for me?
All right, let me see here. I got Man United -1 versus Southampton. I mean, they looked really good in that first game. Southampton, I'm trying to remember what they did last week. Southampton won, right?
They got shit-stomped 3-1.
Oh, by Everton. They were up 1-0. No. Okay. All right. No, I mean, losing Danny Ings was going to hurt them in the scoring department, I think. I don't see them as much of a threat. I didn't see them as much of a threat last season. I think Man United wins that easily, and I got a Bruno goal or assist in that game. I'm starting to take that instead of just a goal or assist because I find that when I bet one, the other happens. So I'll be safe and start betting goal or assist. I got Aston Villa money line versus Newcastle. I think they're a really good team this year. They made, you know, obviously the Grealish deal is going to set them up really nicely. I don't think any player is worth that amount of money, but to get that money coming in is really good for them. I think they're going to bounce back after last week's game. It was a bit of an anomaly against Watford. So I got them there. I got Dortmund -1 versus Freiburg. I got Leipzig -1 versus Stuttgart. Talked about that. Also in the Dortmund game, and I got a Haaland goal. I have a Real Betis -1 versus Cadiz and a Betis clean sheet as well. I got Rui Silva in net over there now coming from Granada. So I don't really have any reason to root for Granada anymore.
Fuck those guys.
Sorry, leg. Or not. Yeah.
Yeah, we're good.
All right. I got Juve -1 for Udinese, and I got a Ronaldo goal there. I think that's really good value there against Udinese. And even though Udinese is home, I think Juventus gets the win to start the season off there. In France, I got Monaco. I bet them last week. They fucked me, but they're playing.
Yes, they're good.
Yeah, they're close to even. They're not quite a pick 'em, but they are you know, minus half against Lens. So I'm going to take that money line. And I'm also going to take the over 2.5. I think someone like Jelson Martins gets on that or someone like that. So we'll see. But I think that's going to be a good bounce back game for Monaco. And I got Lyon
too, by the way.
Yeah, that wasn't fun, but I think they'll have a good bounce back. I think they're going to be in the top three this year in the French league. So we'll take, you know, we'll see how it plays out. Lyon, I'm taking -1 versus Clermont. We talked about that a little bit, and then I like this bet. I have Brentford versus Crystal Palace. I took the over 2. Hearing the Brentford coach talk, I didn't know much about him, but he said he's really going to come out firing and he wants to be in every game. To me, that just sounds like, you know, they're going to be very aggressive and stuff. And when I think of that, I think of goals and, you know, whether it's they're going to win or lose, I think goals are going to be scored. So I think Brentford versus Crystal Palace over 2, and I got a Tony goal in there as well. And I got a couple other picks, but that's pretty much my picks for this week.
Yeah. No, Cotton, so last week we were talking about Brentford. They play a very similar style to Leeds.
Right.
So when they were both
in the defense is better, though.
Brentford's defense because they have Pontus Janssen, the former Leeds defender, which is
right.
Leeds should never let that dude go, but it is what it is.
Right. So they're going to, you know, score and win or get scored on and it'll be a high scoring loss. So that's what I'm kind of hearing. So sounds good to me.
I might have to make this the audience pick, if I'm being completely honest. Fred to score. That's a fucking call.
He scored. He scored last game.
I mean, there's 5 fucking goals.
Yeah, so Fred got one of them. I would never have anticipated that.
That's why it's plus 6,500. Oaks, you got some picks for us?
Yeah, I'm going to do some quick hitters right now for any degenerates out there trying to bet these 7:30 MLS games coming up. I like Seattle. Money line plus 260 right now. I don't know why they're huge dogs against Dallas, but I'm taking Seattle money line plus 260.
Wait, are you on a Rudy Diaz goal?
You goddamn right, I'm on a Rudy Diaz anytime goal, bro. I'm also hitting Sporting KC take Polito or Solari anytime plus 110 plus 15. Both of those got value. Rudy Diaz win cast too. Is always worth a fucking sprinkle. Rudy Diaz is an absolute fucking legend finishing it. That net, that free kick spot he had against the Timbers was sick. Yeah, he should have fucking, he should have had fucking 3. I had him for a hat trick plus 7,000 or whatever the fuck it was, 70-1. So that was a little disappointing he didn't get the hat trick. So that's what I was doing while y'all were talking. I was tuning in and out and putting in my degenerate MLS picks real quick. So here are my picks coming up for the weekend. One second. Gotta find it. Okay, so I got Aston Villa minus 125. Like I said, I think they have a bounce back game in front of the fans here. Brentford draw no bet. I hate Crystal Palace. Took them to relegation. Went over that. Arsenal. I have both teams to score for Brighton versus Waterford at plus 106. Waterford definitely was impressive at home.
Let's see. Watford.
Watford, my bad. Watford was definitely impressive at home. Let's see if they can go on the road in a hostile environment and get one on Brighton. Brighton, huge road win to start the year, so that'll be a great match. Gotta see it. Man U, money line, Pogba, that fucking dude, he is a wagon. I mean, whatever his assist number is, if it's better than 1-1, I'm fucking taking it. Leipzig, goal in both halves, I went over that. Leipzig doesn't come out firing and show why they deserve to fucking be the number 3 team in Bundesliga. I'll probably fade them all year. Wolfsburg plus 135. They got to do better than that after getting an early red card. A 1-0 win is good. It took me to the bank. I made some money, but Wolfsburg's better than that. At the end of last year, they were battling super hard for the top of that table. So I need to see more out of Wolfsburg. I'm going to slam a money line plus 135, build some momentum going into the season. Dortmund, both teams to score and Dortmund to win plus 163. Really like that number. Already went over why Dortmund's a wagon. Already went over why I think Messi's going to score first, because fuck it, Messi's going to score first. Clermont double chance, talked about that. And yeah, Ronaldo anytime, Ronaldo brace, Ronaldo Hattie.
All right, so one, we're a fuck Brighton show, so I'm not even going to tell you have to do that. I'm just going to wait for it to happen where you also just say fuck Brighton. Don't worry, it will. And what was the other one? I was going to say something else about what you picked. Fuck it, I forget. Anyway, we're all on Brentford, though. That's my first one is Brentford. I'm looking at the money line, though. It's plus 185. I might just ride that out. I think they might have one of those, like, newcomer streaks
where
they just get results.
I don't hate it. But I like the plus money on the push for the draw. That's always appealing.
Realistically, I'll probably end up pegging that on my board. But you know damn well that I'm also just going to bet the money line because fuck it.
Right. I sprinkle whenever I take draw no bets, I hammer the draw no bet and I sprinkle the money line just because I want a taste of the high odds. But I definitely like the insurance of getting your money back on the draw.
Yeah, just a couple McDoubles on the fucking money line.
Damn right.
Next one I got is Tottenham money line versus Wolves. I just think they're going to get a result. I'll probably end up putting a Son goal on that as well. I also have Man U minus one versus Southampton because the money line was only one minus 159. So not really juicy enough for me. So I'm going to take Man U minus one. I think that they might shit pump them as well. So we'll see. Then I have Villarreal money line. They owe me a bounce back game. You know, they choked for us, didn't get us a goal.
Fucking they didn't bullshit. Get anything. Nothing happened that whole fucking game. It was bullshit.
It was terrible. I know they are down Chucky Wazy and they're down Danny Parejo, La Liga legend, but no excuses. I just watched you compete with Chelsea for fucking 120 minutes. You should be able to beat some fucking La Liga mid table nobodies. But hey, whatever. Their money. This just helps the odds, though. See, their money line is plus 128, so I'll take that all day. They're playing Espanyol, recently promoted. They play a good brand of football. They know how to play in La Liga, but Villarreal are much more talented. I got Sevilla money line versus Getafe because the line is at plus 120, and I have no idea why. Getafe did nothing to impress me at all. Besides Mark Cucurella, I honestly am not worried about anybody on their team, period. Jamie Mata hasn't really been the same ever since he missed that penalty, so... I'm riding out Sevilla money line. I think it'll probably be a low-scoring game, but it's going to be a Lopetegui ball. Sevilla dominates possession. Sevilla ends up getting the win. Then I got Atletico Madrid versus Elche. I'm taking under 2.5, minus 109. I think Atleti are going to just score one, maybe two on them real quick and easy, and then nothing else is going to happen. They're going to sit back a little bit, hold a little bit more possession than Elche will have. But this is fucking Simeone ball. It's offensive. They got the best goalkeeper on the planet in their net in Jan Oblak. So they're going to keep that zero, and I don't think they score more than two. Suarez, he's not fully fit yet. He did come in off the bench. And, I mean, he's gonna look dangerous. He's Suarez, but you could tell he's not full Suarez yet. This is clearly preseason Suarez still. He was shit jumping off of a boat with Messi a week and a half ago, so he's not completely match fit. Correa looks fantastic, by the way. I think you should definitely take a look at his goals. I still think Yao Felix is due for a big year as well. So Atleti, I think, handled business, and the under is going to hit on that one. And then I got Atalanta minus one. I'll probably take minus 1.5 just because I want more juice on it. And then I'm going to hammer that over as well, over 3.5, because I don't give a fuck. Give me that over. Atalanta puts up goals, especially on match day one. The other one I got is Lazio money line versus Empoli. It's only minus 134 for the money line, which I think is pretty low. Empoli hasn't really bolstered their side to where I think that they'll have a shot against Lazio. I think this is kind of a bounce back season for Immobile after he had a decent Euro. He had a pretty solid Euro, actually, but at his end of last season was rough. He was even missing penalties, and that was kind of his bread and butter to get him to the Golden Boot over in Italy. But I do have Immobile to score as well on that one. And then I got Roma money line versus Fiorentina. Mourinho. My faith is completely Mourinho. I'm going to take a Tammy Abraham goal as well in that. But those are my picks. Moving on to the Parlay Cup. Now, I didn't get a parlay from Cotton. He was busy, as we said. Congratulations, you got engaged. Bond, didn't get your parlay. Did you do a parlay, Bond?
Let me check and see if it hit. It didn't hit. You did do
it. It didn't?
No. I lost all three.
Wow.
My parlay missed by Man City shit. I'm not getting one fucking goal. Are you fucking kidding me?
Same with mine, except your Real Batiste shit the bed and didn't score a fucking goal.
That was fucking plus 800 party looked so good when Son got that fucking shot in. I thought that Tottenham fucking score was such an easy fucking pick after Son got that goal, and then nobody showed up for Man City. Absolute fucking horseshit.
Burr, you can save hold on, you can save those picks for your fucking last week's fuck yous, all right? Don't hit during
anybody watching live, Revs up 2-1 now, by the way. So all we need is Union money line to hit and that fucking no free ads DraftKings boost plus 400 to win hits.
Yeah, buddy.
I was all over that today if you caught me on Twitter.
All right, anyway, back to the Parlay Cup. Cotton, defending champion. I like the little Union update, so you can feel free to keep that. I have a video queue. Like, I'm literally waiting for
the I got the Atlanta game in the background. I got the New England game. I got a TV and my phone that I keep checking, so don't worry.
Cotton, you are defending champion in the Parlay Cup. Do you have a parlay for us, Cotton?
I do. My parlay this week is Man United minus one versus Southampton, Chelsea money line versus Arsenal, and Leipzig minus one versus Stuttgart.
The Leipzig one I think might give you some trouble. That's all I'll say, but that's a solid parlay. Odds are going to be juicy on that one as well.
Yeah, definitely.
Oaks, what do you got parlay-wise?
Parlay-wise? Hold on. Let me grab my book real quick. I'm definitely throwing that Dortmund to win, both teams to score in there. I'm going to throw.
Might as well throw a Haaland goal in that, too.
Haaland's like minus two fucking 25 or some shit again to score anytime. It's shitty odds. That Marco Royce fucking goal was sick, dude. I had him. That was fucking sick. I love that, dude. I'll take Dortmund to win both teams to score. I'll take a Pogba assist, and I'll take a Ronaldo anytime goal probably is my parlay, with the rights to change that at any point given how the numbers move.
The rights to change it at any point. All right, so let's say somebody doesn't score. Do you still have the rights to change it?
No, I'm talking about like between now and Friday.
Really how parlays work.
No, I reserve the right to change that parlay based on how the odds move before the game starts.
I got you.
Betting, typical betting rules. If it's right in before the game, it's good. Yeah.
Right, I'll lock it in and I'll throw it up on the Discord like I did with my MLS picks this weekend.
Bondi, what do you got for the Parlay Cup?
I'm taking Liverpool minus two versus Burnley. Norwich plus 2.5 for City, United minus one versus Southampton, and Chelsea minus one versus Arsenal.
Bro, I'll let you know right now, if we don't fucking beat NYCFC, I'm going to have a fucking conniption. All right, anyway.
It's going to be a tough game. It's going to be a tough game. At home, though, I like Union.
Same. Burnley looks awful. That's usually how your seasons go. Okay. My parlay. And, you know, you got to go Serie A. It's the first week. So I went Roma money line, Tammy Abram to score, Atalanta minus one, Atalanta Torino over 3.5 goals. So honestly, I'm going to do that, and I'll probably add a goal scorer on. It'll probably be Muriel or Zapata just because I'm a twisted individual. But that's what I got for my parlay.
Did you guys see that the People's Parlay hit over the weekend, the 7-leg over 1.5 goal scorers for – plus 750, 780, whatever that was in. Yeah. So I'm going to keep doing that with all English League One games. I like parlays. Obviously, y'all found me on Mooney Gang with Ken, so shout out Mooney Gang. But, yeah, you guys know I love ridiculous parlays. So every week a parlay for every league with I don't know, something ridiculous in it. I like to change it up, but yeah, in that English League One, I'd love doing over 1.5 goals for 5 to 7 teams, and then I like to mix it up. I like to do both teams to score or over 2.5 for the Bundesliga, and then I'll come up with something clever to do for Serie A and French League. The French parlay hit if you weren't up at 5 in the morning like an asshole betting. So
I was up, but it's 7 for my time. Yeah, out of the East Coast, so it's fucking good, baby.
Right, yeah, Central Time. I was still loaded fucking drunk when I made that parlay.
I was messaging you. I remember. So, yeah, that was Parlay Cup. Next, we have our audience pick. So if anyone is in the audience and wants to throw out a pick, last week it hit. Shout out A-Dog. He had Everton Moneyline. Comeback. Hey. So the audience pick is undefeated. Right now you're at 100% audience. So we have 10 people in the chat. I just wrote down a number between 1 and 30 right here in my book. I'm going to let you guys just throw in some numbers if you want to make a pick. Worst comes to worst, I'll just have A-Dog take it again. Man's 100% right now, so you can't really hate those numbers. But if you just put a number in between 1 and 30, we'll take whatever the closest number is. Right now, A-Dog is the only one that wrote in. So I have no problem giving it to him again unless he makes it a Burnley pick. Then it's just kind of like, eh, come on, A-Dog. Grow up a little bit. Yeah, Burr, what number you think I wrote in my book?
7. Obviously, because it doesn't go up to 77.
Everyone's wrong. Nope. Bond, are you just going to keep going up? Or? All right. All right, I'm going to count to 3, and then I'm going to say the number. So speak now or forever hold your peace. Most likely, A-Dog's going to get it, so it's the only number I see. 1, 2, 3. All right, it was 17. Can you see it? Number was 17. So, A-Dog, congrats.
A-Dog, what's your pick?
A-Dog, what is the audience pick this week?
Yeah, nerd.
Ah, oh, man, I know he's trying to look for a Burnley one just because I talk shit on Burnley picks. So let's just Villarreal under. I forget who Villarreal is playing already. Are they playing Espanyol? Villarreal under. What's he under? 2.5, probably?
Probably. Sorry. I like that. Penny La Liga under.
Yo, I can't wait for Oaks to just actually go back and look at the tables where it's like, oh, La Liga has 40 more goals than the EPL does at the end of the season. That's weird. So, yeah, that is the audience pick.
I'm just bitter on that standalone La Liga fucking Tuesday or Monday. I don't fucking know what day it is, but they came up with 0 fucking goals out of 2 games. Come on, man.
Yeah, it was a rough Tuesday, bro. But you know, those Tuesday games aren't easy, man. Now they got a short week, you know? They ain't easy. Tell me how Oaks had to rub in. Also, I woke up to a loss. I was like, damn, Galaxy. And he's like, I told you to do that. I was like, all right, dude, sick.
No, how did you not? Dude, I told you to take Rapids, but if you were a little I told you could take Rapids fucking double chance. It was minus 125 if you were a little bitch.
Yeah, but right when you said that part, I was like, well, fuck, I can't take that one now.
Rapids money line, baby. Let's go.
But anyway, that is everything we got for you guys. This is the Kick 'em, Pick 'em. Make sure you follow us on Twitter at TwoFootTalk, at TWO Foot Talk. You can get everyone's picks. Anytime you tweet us with the picks, we're throwing those picks out there. That's where you can get the People's Parlay and whatever fancy names the rest of us want to make for our parlays. TwoFootTalk on Twitter, TWO Foot Talk. Other than that, make sure you follow us on YouTube, youtube.com/youngleg. For any of the episodes you missed, whole episode will be on YouTube on Thursdays. Other than that, here we go. Good luck, everyone. This has been the Kick 'em, Pick 'em.
Let's burn some bread. Go Seattle.